Hey, everybody, we're live now on the Las Vegas Rocks radio show. There's the great Rose Kingsley, Mystic Mona, Neil Portnoy, Tom Hillary, and Lou Gazzara is back from the boat. He's right there. There's Lou right there. Hey, Lou, you're on this. We got it. He'll be in the shot when we go. And we're getting ready to go, so everybody be happy. Janice Bovino's watching. Hey, Janice. So we're all set. We're going to be starting the show when you hear the jingle. 24 seconds.
Okay.
Let's get ready.
You can get cozier over here.
You guys can squeeze together if you like.
This one's kind of erotic.
I can be cozier.
Cozy. Cozy.
Here we go.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Here we go.
Okay.
It's the Las Vegas Rocks radio show, the show before the show. Join us for a fast-paced hour of celebrity interviews and entertainment news. And now, here's Ron.
Las Vegas Rocks!
And welcome, everybody, to the Las Vegas Rocks radio show. I'm your host, Ron Garrett. Join me and the famous illustrator to the stars, Mr. Genius over at the Portnoy Gallery, Neil Portnoy. Hello, Neil.
Hello, Ron. 4th of July weekend. Let's make it a good one.
A good weekend for the 4th of July. We like the 4th of July. It's going to be one of the coolest 4th of Julys in two decades, I think,
yes,
something like that.
Correct.
Under 100 degrees. Sitting right next to Neil there is a movie maker, inventor, and who said take the microphone away? You're already with the movie maker and inventor. What else are you? Executive producer of the show, yeah, Mr. Tom Hillary.
Hello,
Tom.
Sounds good. Hi there, Ron.
Tom recently directed a movie overseas by phone. We ought to find out about that. Right next to Tom is our good buddy there, Mr. Las Vegas, soon to be the king of sing.
Leaning into the view.
Leaning into the view. Vegas headliner Lou Gazzara and star of the Black Tie Vegas TV show. Hello, Lou.
Hello. Thanks for having me on.
Got your sea legs?
Yeah, absolutely.
You got your land legs?
I got land legs.
Yeah. Land legs. Which one is it? Sea level?
Land, whatever.
You were up.
Made out of wood.
You're out fishing. Egg legs. What you were doing, yeah. Out fishing. Also, he's not only an inventor, Tom. He's also a Fortune 500 honoree. He's in the magazine. Yeah.
Wow.
He's one of the 500 fortunate guys in Vegas to be in that magazine. So congratulations on that, Tim. Tom. Also, we welcome to the studio the
Lost
Vegas.
Fortune.
No, okay. The Vegas Diva. The Vegas Diva, opera and jazz star, Miss Rose Kingsley.
Hello.
Hello, Rose. You guys playing with that mic again? I can hear it. I think it's working now, right, everybody?
So far,
it's working.
That's good.
That's because Mona's next to me.
Do not
That's
jinx.
Because Mona. So as I was saying, the Vegas Diva, opera and jazz star, Rose Kingsley. Look, you got a lot working for you there, Rose. We'll be talking about it in just a minute. And right next to Rose is Vegas's most popular psychic.
Thank you.
Licensed psychic, we have
Thank
to say that.
Thank you very
that.
Much.
The always mysterious Mystic Mona.
That would be me.
That would be you. And, of course, as we said, Lou is back from the cruises as well. On the phone at 5:30, the winner of the Best Lounge Singer in Las Vegas, according to Las Vegas Weekly magazine, Mr. Nicholas Cole. Hello, Nicholas. He'll be calling in just a little bit. So we'll start the conversation shortly, but first my disclaimer. All the music we play today is fully authorized and licensed. This is a broadcast radio station. And they subscribe to all the publishing houses, ASCAP, BMI, CSAC, and any others I can think of.
LPGYOVQ.
Is there any other besides ASCAP, BMI, CSAC?
8675.
BMI?
No, those are the publishing companies.
I think that's enough.
So that's plenty, right? So we are legally covered by that, so Facebook don't cut me off like you did last couple of, about a month ago.
Right.
But we are legal. And every time I fight them, they say, okay, you're right, you are. It's a radio station.
After the fact.
They have all this stuff going. So, but now let's do our shout outs for a few seconds here. Neil, you got a shout out this morning?
Shout out to Dorothy, my wife. We've got events. We'll talk about it later. Fabulous Dorothy, yeah.
The fabulous Dorothy.
Yeah, and then
the magnificent Neil and the fabulous Dorothy.
Yeah, and then we'll talk about Ron's cousins, which seemed to keep multiplying in Florida.
Well, I had started with seven of them. I'm sure they were pretty
decreasing. Are we losing
it? Well, yeah, we did. They get old. It happens. I'm going to say hello to my honey, Tammy. She's listening right now. I love you, baby. She's my biggest fan. Hello, Tammy. Everybody say hello. Hi, Tammy.
Hi, Tammy.
Also, her sister recently back from France, Christy Tice. Hey, Christy. Bonjour. How do you say, did you have a good... Who speaks French? Anybody?
Nobody. No. Nope.
Frenchman.
How do you say, did you have a good time in French? French. Yeah, French.
Avez-vous un bon chance? Bon temps.
Bon ton.
Avez-vous un bon ton?
You have to do that. Bon. You got to move your mouth. In a bon ton. Can you do French? You do speak French?
Certain moments I can, yes.
You speak Boston is what you speak.
I packed the gun in the oven.
Sure.
Let's say hello to Sam Shockley and Patrick Barney of Vegas Beyond the Strip. Their new show starts next week on Go Live Vegas app, the Vegas Beyond the Strip radio show, hosted by...
Aaron Elikas?
No, yours truly, Ron Garrett.
The fabulous.
Produced by Aaron Elikas.
That's right. Yeah.
I read the second line.
That's
first.
Right. Produced by Aaron Elikas. But I host that radio show, which will run every Saturday and Sunday now on the Go Live Vegas app.
Are you going into studio to do it?
I already did it.
Excellent.
I already did it. You know, it's easy. It's that was, here is. You know, you do it that way.
And they just keep playing the same thing back and forth.
And they're playing great songs. He's going to show Kelly Vaughn and Carmen Mandia and Carmine, rather, and just about everybody.
They do a good show,
and it should be a lot of fun. So yeah. They've been producing shows down there at Rainmaker Productions, down at their studios, and they've got 60 hours of programming that they're going to put on TV as well.
Maybe we get Rose another gig. I mean, she's got like a zillion coming up. What's one more?
Rose hasn't had any time to sleep right now, you know, besides moving in and doing all that stuff. That's right. Hello to Jerry Walker up in Reno. Hey, Jerry, one of the best insurance men in the business, and a casino master. He's fantastic at the casino business. He was my casino manager back in the day.
I got to ask you, Michael Grimm just came out with a new album called The Red Album. And one of the songs on the album is Jerry Walker.
Really? Well, I don't think they know each other.
Well, I hope they don't, because it's not a very pleasing type flattering thing about Jerry Walker.
Jerry's a great guy. Matter of fact, he's a big guy. You better watch out, you know, what he said.
Was he an insurance agent?
He's a casino executive, and he's selling insurance now.
Oh, well, maybe.
And my other buddy, Marty Party, the Marty Party, he's up on Lake Tahoe right now on his boat.
Yep.
And they're watching the show on their iPads out in the middle of Lake Tahoe, out in the middle of Lake Tahoe, not the middle, the middle.
Right in the middle.
Right in the middle.
Is it a big lake?
Say hello to Janet Conway in New Jersey and Gene Ferrari down in Florida, soon to be coming to Vegas to do a show. Hello, Janet. We're waiting for that date for Gene's show.
Yeah, we've been waiting 3 months for Gene again.
That's right, but he's coming. He's working on it. We're going to get some more information pretty soon this week.
Just don't go Delta Airlines, because it'll be another 3 months before you get it.
I understand Delta was...
$10,000 a seat.
That's right. Yeah. I understand Delta was one of the better airlines.
Well, they're not doing well.
You know, also, we say hello to Go Live Vegas app. That's Aaron Elikas and Raquel Elikas. Yeah. Bob Anderson, he was here last week. Thank you, Bob. Over 500 views at this point for the Bob Anderson being on our show. Jay White was here. And Jay's a fantastic artist, and he sold out 3 nights there at the South Point.
Yeah, we had a great show. We had Elvis.
Yeah, we're going to have Elvis Neil soon. Diamond. We're going to have Elvis soon. We had Elvis and Neil, a lot of people.
And Mr. Clean.
We have Tommy and Janie, a rocker down in Florida, right in Florida. They moved. They're back in Maricopa, Arizona. PJG and Maria, he's recovering from neck surgery. I hope you're better by now. I want to say hello to Rich Natoli and Rick Michaels.
The Jew Man Group.
Which is doing very well over the Tuscany. Go see it. It's one of the funniest shows in town. Hello to our friends at the Italian American Club, as always. Jimmy and Angela. And, of course, Ben. And they have more shows over there than Caesar's Palace. And most of them are better, you know, than Caesar's Palace. You know,
more affordable.
Adele won't be appearing anytime soon. We're glad about that. So go see the Jew Man Group with Rich Natoli and Rick Michael. They're fantastic. And the third guy, I can't think of his name.
Right? Very well-known name. I don't know it offhand. But
I thought you knew everything.
I don't know everything, no.
Oh, okay. Also,
maybe tomorrow.
All the live music venues here in town. We'd like to thank them for having live music venues, really. But it's sad to say that we've lost one of them. Recently, we've heard that the Mosaic has closed its doors.
Yep.
Due to fire hazards or something of that order. And we're going to miss the great shows that were there. The Piano Man show was fantastic. The Michael Jackson show with Michael Firestone was fantastic. Yep. And, of course, our favorite Elizabeth Diega, who was the Queens of Rock, and she won't be there right now. But those shows are good.
They were good. And they'll find another place.
We don't like to see. There it goes. Wiggle the back end there.
That's what she
testing,
said.
Testing, testing. Yeah, back.
We don't like to see places closed.
No, we don't like to see the
hope they get their act together.
Yep. Yep.
And also, Barbara Brighton did a nice job at the Starlight Barn. She was up there, and she had a pretty good show going, and she had a lot of fun, and we saw some pictures. Congratulations, Barbara. You did a great job. Also, hello to Bronx Wanderers, who are out of town this weekend. They're performing back east. They'll be back tomorrow afternoon at 6 o'clock. Tickets start at $54. Go see the Bronx Wanderers at the Westgate. Also, Menopause the Musical. That's also on now. It's not closed. They're there 8 o'clock at night. On Saturdays, it's a 4 o'clock and 8 o'clock. On Tuesdays, a 4 and an 8. And their tickets started to save. They started at $54.
Yes. Has that show changed over the years? It's the longest running, one of, if not the longest running show in Las Vegas.
They've updated some of the parody music. It, yeah.
Is Menopause the same 30 years later for women? Because I don't know. I'm asking for a friend.
I think so. I don't want to go there with that.
Yeah, they probably don't.
Sometimes it lasts 30 years. You got to be careful.
Maybe they need to send us a hot flash.
There you go.
All right, there you go.
They have hot flash fans that they give away during the show. It's really
very clever.
It's really cute. It really is. Also, we want to say hello to Denny and Meyer Lansky. They listen all the time. How are you guys doing? I think they're up in Tahoe right now. And we did say Barbara Brighton. Right? We'll say it again. Barbara Brighton.
Speaking of the,
did she get a ride yet? Go ahead.
No, she didn't call. I turned her off. Mario Lansky, I was heard they're going to do a show about the mob, and he and Danny were going to be somewhat involved. Have you heard anything about that?
They were going to do a show called The Mob Story, which was down at the Plaza a few years ago with Michael Francesi, who was actually a mobster.
Correct.
This is the show. And Frankie Citro was involved in it. And this is the show they're talking about, and it was supposed to go to Mosaic.
No
chance of that right now. They might open again. I hope they do. We want that place open so people have places to work. You know. Also, hello to Stefano DeSantos. He is he's producing stuff all over the place, including the show you did with him last night, Rose.
Correct.
Well, we're going to get to that in just a little bit. But first, we're going to take a break, and we're going to go to break with you, Rose, singing that old Black Magic, and we'll be right back with Rose and Mona, Neil, Tom, and Lou.
Do-do-do. And it's that old black magic that you so.
I'm gonna play your. I'm gonna play your go live by. Then you spot on the other side.
Yeah. Down my spine.
Live.
Said of witchcraft and God as be mine. Said of healing death and feel inside. Then that hell may.
We're going to come back with Rose and find out what that's all about, where you sang that. It's a beautiful song, Old Black Magic. And when we come back, tell us all about it, okay?
Okay, real dear.
We'll bring it up a little bit more, and let's take a break right now. All right, never mind. Just take a break. Do one or the other.
Here we go.
Sorry, Rose.
Okay. You recovered very nicely. Nice segue.
Yeah, all right. When we come back, we'll start the conversation.
300 experts talking about politics, culture, and investing. Hear and meet Senator Rand Paul talking about
his famous confrontations with Dr. Fauci.
I saw that. You know what? It took him 20 minutes to give it away. People didn't want the 10 grand. They wanted to go in there again. I'm taking the 10 grand.
I don't know if it was cash or with a future consideration.
Well,
they
said cash.
It was a Visa card or a PayPal.
They said cash.
That's right.
I would have given up. I'd give you the 10 grand.
I don't reply at all. I say where I was.
Spent a couple of days where I was.
The rent of the car.
They have to still fly you the next day.
Oh, really?
To your next destination. And put you in the hotel. Sometimes
they'll
fly you
first
class the next day.
Yeah, but we're alive right now. Everybody can't be heard. No bad mouthing anymore.
No, we're not using
it. No, I'm just saying.
No bad language. I know, I'm just kidding.
Yeah.
1 minute. 1 minute, and I'm back.
You write everything in that little pad,
This is just
make it big letters so we can see it.
When medical emergencies arise, we meet the challenge. In cybersecurity.
Cybersecurity. Ready for a drop in.
So I've rediscovered the charcoal room, and I was
this is Blue One America.
It is such a
And we're back, everybody, on the Las Vegas Rocks Radio Show. I'm your host, Ron Garrett, here on AM 670 KMZQ, speaking with Rose Kingsley, Mystic Mona, Neil Portnoy, Tom Hillary, and Lou Gazzara. Let's go over here to Rose. Hey, Rose.
Hey.
I want to talk a little bit to you here. Okay. From what is it, Irvington, New Jersey?
Irvington, New Jersey.
Irvington, New Jersey. Let me tell people a little bit about you, okay?
Okay.
And that way they understand who we're talking to. And so, well, a lot of people don't know yet. They will.
Yeah.
You're certainly getting out there and getting the word out. You are a magnificent opera and jazz singer. You sing songs from the Met all the way to Vegas, to just about every gender, von venue, whatever it is, you do it. You sing everything. It's fantastic. Welcome to Vegas.
Thank you.
You just got a new house. Yeah. You deserve it. You deserve that kind of house. You say you're a Renaissance woman?
Yeah, so you can explain that a little bit? Well, you know, sometimes I feel I should have lived back in the 14, 1500s because I'm into the classics and in the time, well, actually, you know, the time of Puccini, which is the early, late 1800s, early 1900s. And I love Italy. And so I kind of feel, yes, I'm Renaissance in that sense.
Woman.
Yeah.
You've sung for three presidents.
I have.
Bush one.
Yes.
Gerald Ford.
Yes.
Bill Clinton.
Uh-huh.
You've performed with Pavarotti.
I have.
Sinatra.
Uh-huh.
Bob Hope.
Uh-huh.
Vic Damone.
Uh-huh.
Connie Francis.
Uh-huh.
And a whole bunch I didn't want to write down.
Oh, Placido Domingo.
Placido, who else?
Placido.
Got a long list.
A long list. Catherine Grayson.
There you go. And you studied at Juilliard.
I did.
Vocal performance at Juilliard.
Yes, I did.
Okay. So that brings everybody up to date on who you are.
Okay.
Now tell us what's next.
What's next? Well, I love being here in Vegas. It offers a lot of great opportunity to also bring my school, the International Opera Institute, to Vegas. And we're putting that together, and I'm bringing in two conductors from the Metropolitan Opera to work with me here. And open it up to artists who are interested in a career in singing. Also taking opera singers who are interested in crossover, which I do, from opera to pop and jazz. So there's an art to that. And I'm here to work with them, and we already have quite a few singers who want to work with us. And on top of that, we will be doing some opera performances in the area. And of course, as far as my great American songbook career goes, I'm now recording at Capitol Records, and I did a recording there with the Mercers right before the pandemic in February of 2020. And now I was asked to come back to Capitol and do another CD, another recording, which we're deciding, what do I want to do? You know, that's going to be very interesting.
Last night you performed at the Sterling Club.
I did. What an elegant place.
How'd that go?
That was great. I did three Great American Songbook songs, and I even did an aria, which I think blew people away. Mm-hmm. They were like, all of a sudden everybody got really quiet. And it was fun. It was. And today I had a rehearsal with the great Bill Fain, and we're doing a show together on July 10th at the Summerlin Performing Arts Center.
A week from tomorrow.
It's also my birthday. I know, July 10th.
It's my birthday the day before.
That's right.
That's right.
It is. Yeah. Oh,
I don't have birthdays anymore. No, I have anniversaries of 30. It sounds so
beautiful. Do you celebrate the day you lost the last of your hair? Did you celebrate that?
Actually, I do. It was my first divorce.
Oh, okay. That's the day you lost your mind.
That's right. Yeah. A lot okay. more.
If you only
Did
lost
you pull your hair out?
Yeah, yeah. I got a quick question for Rose.
Yes.
What intrigued me is you started to mention about schooling young singers in the genres which you're most famous for, which is the opera.
Right.
I think that's a great idea with the Smith Performing venue we have here and right. the intrigue of getting the talent, which, as you know, is incredible here in Vegas, and schooling them and starting that direction for them. I think that's a brilliant idea.
Oh, I'm excited about that because there's a part of me that I really enjoy teaching. And living in the desert in Palm Springs, there really wasn't that opportunity. Where here, I'm finding that opportunity, and one of the reasons I'm here, too.
Well, that was going to be one of my questions. What made you move from Palm Springs to Las Vegas?
Well, I moved to Palm Springs originally because...
Where were you before that, before you went to Palm Springs?
I was, when I moved from New York to Monterey because okay. I was a professor at Cal State Monterey. Uh-huh. And voice. And then I had the opportunity to become dean of the opera department at Chapman University in Palm Desert. And it became so successful that they moved it to Orange County, which I didn't want to move to Orange County. And then I started the International Opera Institute in Palm Springs. But as the years went on, less and less new artists came to Palm Springs. As we know, it's a retirement community. So,
too many old people there, Rose? Okay.
Who are you calling old?
Yeah, right.
The people around us, not us.
Right.
So we felt that Las Vegas was the opportunity not only for me to perform, but to bring the IOI here and train young singers who, and I have quite a staff, I do. Gregory Buchalter, conductor from the Metropolitan Opera, William Vendice from the Metropolitan Opera, and Alan Glassman, leading tenor at the Metropolitan Opera, and they're all coming out here to work with me, so that's exciting. So yes, on July 10th, I'm doing a show with Bill Fang called A Trifecta of Music. We're doing jazz, we're doing Broadway, and we're doing opera we're bringing Alan Glassman. It's gonna be exciting, and then,
well, we'll come back to some more of that in just a minute. You don't do it all at once. I got a whole hour to do right now.
I was just going to ask real quickly, with Bill Fane, you're practicing in the new rotunda of your
Yes, room? Today was the first day. Oh, my gosh, it was so exciting. I said to Norm, you've got to video this. The sound was incredible.
Nice.
He's such a great pianist.
That's at your new house. That's what we're talking
yes.
about.
Yes.
Now, you need to have Miss Dick Mona come over to your new house.
Oh, you will.
So she can chase all the ghosts out of the closet.
Please do. Right.
Miss Dick Mona, been on Jimmy Kimmel. You're an author. You've been on Sister Wives. You have your own radio show, the Psychic View radio show. You were on Aaron's Hour today.
I was.
You were. You were out there cheating on me this morning. Right?
Honey, there's nobody in the world like you.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Don't cheat on me, Dad.
Not nobody.
You are an intuitive tarot consultant.
Yes.
And you do parties and weddings and bachelorette parties. Can we get an invitation to any of those?
Bachelorette parties. Those are fun.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Trade shows, slot tournaments, product launches, all you. Tell us a little more about Miss Dick Mona.
What do you want to know?
I want to know how they can get a hold of you to hire you or bring you in. This is a show that plugs our local entertainers.
I love that. But I had this immediate insight for Rose. Can I share that instead?
Absolutely.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So I love that you're going into teaching and nurturing young voices. What I would really love to see, and with the brain trust that's in this room, you probably could make it happen, is I would love to see a contest for these young people.
Ah,
where
yes.
you actually do, Vegas Got Opera kind of talent, where, and actually that could be the name, Vegas Got Opera. And that what you do is you actually get these kids.
Careful. The last time you used that, you said you haven't arrived in Vegas until you've been Portnoyed. And look what happened to that.
Yeah,
it came with her.
Well,
so be careful.
When you just said that, I got a chill.
I'm getting a chill telling you that. So see, here's the thing.
You want to turn the lights off or anything?
It's not that kind of chill.
Okay.
just saying.
No, the air conditioner is up a little high.
Whatever. But what I'm trying to tell you is that you have some really great minds in this room right now. And I actually think that you could get an amazing sponsor for the contest. And that you could fill the room with all these wonderful local people to actually, you know, be the audience. I would tape it, and then I would submit it to the Learning Channel for an actual annual event.
I think also what you could do is very similar to piggyback on what Park West Galleries did, the Made in Vegas competition, which in a lot of ways built an existing database of emails. So you've got your client base by throwing the contest out there. People are applying. Now you've got your base of fans to start social media marketing.
Right. And now people would not necessarily have to be a student of yours.
Right, correct.
In order to compete. But I think that the way to do the contest would be to have them learn 10 different songs.
Right.
Right. And they pull the song out of a hat, and that's the song they sing.
That sounds good. Why don't you guys have lunch?
We will.
And try and work that out. And work it over.
I'm telling you, there are so many networking groups that all we want to do is fill the audience. All you want to do is do the first one.
Yep.
Correct.
And then you find a sponsor for the prizes, and it's not a participation prize. There's first, second, and third. And it's not a participation prize for people to just get up there and sing.
Right.
It literally.
No, I'm serious. You two guys need to have lunch to talk this over. Because you know, we could be on all day talking about your idea.
Right. But anyway, but I'm just telling you.
I love it.
You know, it's a great idea.
Great idea, Mona.
It's a great idea. But right now, I have to go to break.
Oh, okay.
Okay. And taking us to break is none other than the great Lou Gazzara. Luck be a lady tonight.
I love this song. Love that song.
Tara Walsh or something. Oh no, this is with Natasha. But sure, she doesn't live here anymore.
Okay, you want to break that? Okay, we come back. We're going to chat with Tom a little bit.
Okay.
And then Mona, we're going to come back to you and Rose. But
we got Nick too.
And I got to do that, yeah. You know, I got time to do that. And we got Nick on the phone.
Hello?
Jam pat that.
Yeah. I got some great news about Rose.
Keep it short.
Yeah, we're
going to
do a commercial break in about a minute and a half, and Ron will get right to
Rose. Yeah.
I'm very excited to have this. You'll be able to hear the stage.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
It's a monster.
As you know, you've seen my show, you know I can sing in all different styles. I'd love to talk with you about
Vegas and
that's what I'm trying to get them to do.
Okay, 30 seconds. Right before that. Yeah. Okay. Right there. Right there. Just before she starts talking.
You going through menopause?
No, I'm just suddenly really warm. Like someone just turned the heater off. Maybe it's a flash. It's a flash, baby.
The 30-year flash.
What's up?
No, she said it's a little warm in here.
Oh. Here we go.
Okay, stand by. And we're back on the Las Vegas Rocks Radio Show. I'm Ron Garrett, your host, right here on KMZQ. 670 AM on Saturday at 5 o'clock. A great show. And great talking to Mr. Tom Hillary. Tommy.
Yes, we are. Hi, Ron.
So I understand that you tell us how you directed a movie by phone overseas.
Well, actually, let me give you some interesting news first. You know that Looks Can Kill I've been talking about?
Your movie that you have out now.
Murder and Vengeance stocks the modeling agency. We got some really cool numbers just came out.
Okay, what
One venue alone, 460,000 views, a couple weeks ago total. That is enough to fill a Colosseum at Caesar's Palace, according to you, 115 times. So I'm happy about that.
Caesar's has 4,000 people at the palace.
You do the math, we come up with 115.
And if you're on this show right now, you're talking to a sold-out audience at Caesar's. We've got that size.
Exactly.
That's where we are. So that's how I always put the two together. And as many people listen to this, watch this, as it are at Caesar's Palace, sold out at the Colosseum. Okay.
See what I mean? So anyhow,
I got to get a plug-in for the show.
Absolutely, man. Okay, so the good news is go to 2B TV and watch Looks Can Kill. You'll be joining 500,000 people.
Okay.
There's the good news there. Now, you want the news about, like, directing movies from across the ocean?
If it only takes 20 seconds.
20 seconds, yeah. Well, the finale of Honey Trap didn't come out right. I had to, like, direct it from over here while they were reshooting it over in England.
You did? How do you do that?
You have to do that through the WhatsApp video call. And have a guy over there who's the production supervisor holding up the phone and showing you what they're
doing.
So
what are you seeing? You're seeing the set acting?
Yeah, you see the actors, you see the set, you see how everybody's moving, you see if they're doing it right or if they're doing it wrong, and you correct it. Okay. Never tried to do that across a continent and an ocean before, so that was a new experience.
Technology, it's amazing.
It is.
It's totally amazing. It is. Amazing. Thanks, Tom. Appreciate that. Hey, Mona, I got something here. I think you appeared on Sister Wives. Listen to this.
Oh, are they ones that fell out? Do they mean anything?
Yeah, there are some friendships that you need to let go of that are not really friendships.
This is Mona on Sister Wives, one of the shows that she appeared in. And I found this on the YouTube for you.
You're a keeper.
The other card is sort of a past life card.
You can see it on the video.
You're not supposed to actually have the big love until you...
I have a career.
And so you have a career. That there, you need to contribute to the real world before you procreate.
Oh, really? Well, I love you.
Okay.
I love you.
Can I run the rest of this before you what? That's fair. It was Sister Wives, wasn't it?
Right.
Did you have a good time?
I did. But what was so funny is that as I'm listening to that, well, you know, there was this show about polygamy on HBO called Big Love, which is interesting because I use those words.
Bill Paxton.
And then the other thing, yes, very good. And then the other thing is that the gal that I did the reading for, I believe it was her birthday, and she was turning 17 or 18, and I was making it very, very clear that she had to do something before it was all about boys and babies. And so the mom was sitting there going, I love you. That's great.
On the phone right now is our good friend from the Italian American Club. Bring him on in. Hey, Nicholas Cole.
Hi, Ron. How you doing?
How you doing?
I'm off to that talented panel of yours.
Yeah, thank you. Listen, I understand you won the Best Lounge Act on the Vegas Weekly Award as the best in Vegas, huh?
I'm really thankful and very blessed for it.
Well deserved. well-deserved
someone creating a channel in this town. I'm just very thankful. I can't do any more blessing things for what's going on at the time American Club and all the great stuff there and what's going on in my life with my family, my five kids, and my beautiful wife, Danielle. And I'm just, things are really clicking, and things are going very well for me right now.
Are you appearing tonight at the Italian American Club with Billy Fisher, maybe?
Tonight I have we have Carmen Romano.
Oh, yeah, we like Carmen Romano. He's great.
And in the ballroom, I think it's, I'm not too sure who's in the ballroom. I think it's Ken Foote and the Goodfellas.
Oh, they're great. They always do a good job.
Yeah, they always are.
Nicholas, Neil Portnoy here. Congrats on the award. Well deserved, my friend. But I got a question. Five kids, do you ever get up for breakfast?
We don't have a TV. We just got a TV lately. We have 16 year old twins, so we really have 16 year old twins, and my beautiful wife Danielle, and what can I say, you got it all going, my friend,
we're very proud of you.
Yeah, we'll be down to see you, Nicholas. I know you're there all the time. You've got like a long residency going. You're doing a great job. Once again, congratulations. You sang with some terrific singers. Have you sang with Nick Cole yet?
I did one, yes.
Nick. This is Rose Kingsley on the phone, Nicholas.
Oh, yeah, hi, Rose. Hi. You know what? The past couple of nights were really magical at the Italian American Club. We had Bob Anderson do a back-to-back sold-out show on Thursday night, and it was just magical. It brings back Vegas. I mean, there's nothing happening in the world like what's going on here at the Italian American Club. Like people like Lou Gazzara, I know he's there on a panel. He comes in and the people go crazy. There's only Bowie, Steve McCoy. I mean, it's just unbelievable how many great entertainers come through the Italian American Club.
As I said, more talent there than at the Caesar's Palace for sure. Nicholas, thank you so much for calling in. I appreciate it. I can't wait till you get a night off on a Saturday so you can come to the studio and be with us down here.
I will, and you guys can come down. Please come down anytime. I'm there Wednesday to Sunday, and also at Buddy V's, the Cake Boss Restaurant, on Sunday afternoon, and Tuesday night.
Well, you're a busy guy. Congratulations on the Best of Vegas Award. Tough to get. Good job, man.
Thank you, Ron, and thanks for taking me tonight.
You bet. Talk to you soon. Nicholas Cole, everybody. Yeah, we like Nicholas Cole, don't we? How about you, Lou? We got Lou Gazzara. Why don't you slide over to get into the camera range, Tom, if you could just...
I'm going to be very delicate.
Yeah, we want to get Lou on.
One finger push. Can everyone hear me? I'm not on the ears here, but hello to everyone, and thanks for having me on. Appreciate
First of all,
it.
Everybody needs to know who Luke is. Lou is Gazzara Entertainment, studied philosophy at Catholic University of America.
Yes.
Went to St. Joseph High School in New Jersey. American Idol finalist. A singer. This is what the quote is. I love this quote, Lou. A singer with fever and funk, grit and class, soul and sizzle. That's hot stuff, that is. Three-time Broadway nominee and the master of the cruise ships, Lou Gazzara.
How's it going?
Sounds good, huh?
That sounds really
If you could
good.
Only live up to all this, it would be terrific.
Right? One night only. July
27th. That's two interviews in a row that both have twins. Nicholas has got twins, Lou's got twins.
There you go.
I do. Serafina and Maximus just turned a year and a half. Big milestone, 18 months. And Presley's here the whole summer. He's going to be turning 7. But they can't go to the Italian American Club on July 27th for my show. That's a little too
What's
much.
The show going to be about?
Well, it's we're going to do a pretty special lineup with the musicians that we have here. We have Stephen Lee on guitar.
Great guitarist.
An absolute monster. Amazing. Goes out with Donnie. Osmond and Marie Osmond, I should say, all the time when they go on tour. We've got Keith Nelson on bass, who is one of the first calls whenever David Foster wants to do performances with musicians from Las Vegas. We've got my musical director, Robbie Wingfield, on keys, who has been performing all over the town. He's been in Palazzo. He's been all these different shows. He's ran things for the Las Vegas Tenors. He does all these charts. So he'll be running everything for me. And then on drums, we have Pepe Jimenez, who has been over at your Wham parties on Tuesday nights. And Pepe, as we know, is
Pepe.
Just the unbelievable percussionist, multi-percussion, not just a drummer. He's just everything that can be hit, yep. Slap, bang, boomed, he does it. And we're gonna throw some different some of that different fervor, sizzle, grit, and all that good stuff.
I love that. That's a great quote.
We're throwing all of that into this particular show. This is going to be the hot summer, you know, sizzle that we're talking
about.
Are you
going to do some Elvis in that show since the movie's so popular right now?
Absolutely.
Yeah, I got some of that for you right here. Listen to this. This is Lou, everybody, not Elvis.
Wow.
I at least play telephone. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Now, maybe if I made you mad for something I might have said, please let's forget the past. Well, the future looks bright ahead. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. I don't wonder what I love. I may be easy to see the one, but then you
one more, Lou, one more.
Little mother hound dog, crying all the time. Well, you ain't never caught a rabbit and you ain't no friend. Well, you said you was high class. Well, that was just a lie. Well, I said you was high class. Well, that was just a lie.
Have you seen the movie yet, Lou?
I haven't.
Oh, the movie was great.
No, I haven't seen it.
Have you seen it, Rose?
No. I loved it.
You saw it?
I haven't seen it yet. But I gotta say, how good was that?
That's
I know.
That's unbelievable. Lou, you're amazing.
Along with that guy. I mean, that's pretty...
Well, listen,
that's on my album, Musical Love Affair, in case anybody was wondering. You can go to lucasara.com. All the information of everything that we have going on is there, including Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, regular email, all the good stuff. The schedules, photos, videos galore, everything you want to see, lucasara.com.
What you got, Tom?
Yeah, I was going to say, I'm not a promoter, but Priscilla herself was at South Point, and she recommends this movie.
She so, does. Yeah, well, she
actually said it's a
don't
good
get
movie.
Me started. Yeah, it was a good movie. They were involved in it.
Yeah, but for her to say it, it counts.
Yeah, well, I'll get my opinion about that later. Right now, let's go back to Rose and Mona. Mona, do you mind doing a reading with Rose right now?
I would love to do a reading.
Let's do that. Let's do a reading.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mystic Mona is... Now, Rose said it's fine as long as it's all good. Mystic Mona doing a reading with Rose Kingsley.
Hold on, I'm going
and by the way,
talk.
Let's say hello to Norm back there. Hey, Norm Miller.
Hi,
he's
Norm.
In the room. He's back there. And, of course,
this
one's of course Mark Thomas, our studio producer and the morning man here on KMZQ, 670 AM, 6 to 9 every morning.
Okay.
Here we go.
Play five aces, please. Not those type of guys. My bad.
With your left hand,
okay.
Draw me five cards and leave it face down.
Oh, this is fun. Right now she's drawing five cards and leave face down. And
so you realize this year is my 20th anniversary.
Congratulations, man. Yes. We hear we need that dun,
yeah.
Dun, 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 dun.
Okay.
That one?
You will have all five windows
I think
of
Jeopardy
of the Tesla intact when you
Tesla's made some people mad.
Well, they had a window broken, that's why.
Yeah,
but Elon's laying off 200 people in San Mateo. So, okay, but
all
back
right.
to you.
Okay.
This is the luckiest card in the whole deck.
Oh, wow. Gee.
Okay, now, here's what's so interesting is that against the odds, you followed your heart to come here. And I know that sounds like a weird thing to say, but it's saying here you weren't listening to any of the naysayers. You weren't listening to anybody that was probably talking against the move.
Mm-hmm.
You just followed your heart. That's literally what this
Amen.
Means. Now that you're here, you're kind of recreating your tribe. You're recreating your people around you
Thank
right
you.
Now. And I do want you to trust your intuition about being tentative about who you jump in bed with, okay? And I don't mean that literally.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Unless it's Kevin Costner.
Unless it's, well, yeah. You know, we all have, we have the one pass. We all have that one pass.
Okay.
But these are minor cards compared to these two cards. So notice that this card looks like a Polaroid camera
yes.
picture. All right. When you take a picture of something too close with a Polaroid camera and you develop, it's going to look just like this. When you get it like this, it means that you think that you have to follow someone else's rules to get what you want, but you have it this way, which means it's you following your rules the way you want to do it to get what you want, and you're not going to apologize for it. But you have connected to this five-year potential, which is huge. What this is saying is that this is the luckiest card in the deck, which means you being in the right place at the right time to meet the right people in the right, you know, second, right? Uh-huh. And being prepared to meet them. So what I love about this card is that you're sitting calm in the center, mm-hmm. and it's like you're sitting calm in the center with the brass ring right next to you, right, of a merry-go-round. And that the merry-go-round is going around you, and you have a choice of jumping onto whatever animal is in the merry-go-round. But I want you to wait for the right animal, okay? Mm-hmm. You wait till the unicorn comes around, basically, right? And don't get any naughty in there, but you know where I was going with this. But what this is saying is you stay calm and still, and you wait for the thing to circle around that you want in front of you. Don't chase anything, all right? Okay. But this is saying your way is the right way, so don't second guess yourself, okay?
Okay.
But that's the luckiest card in the deck, and you're going to see some huge breakthroughs starting in October, and then the 5 months after October, there's going to be a lot that happens. I mean, it could be that you end up four-walling your own showroom eventually, and that when you do that, what happens is that everybody around you actually helps you fill it with talent. Yeah.
That's a good reading.
It's very good. I mean, she chose these cards.
Can I take this card now? Because you said it's a little
Well, it'd be funny.
Take it home with you?
We'll see if you get it.
We'll come back to have you done in just a minute. Right now, we'll take a break. Going into the break, let's do a plug for the Go Live Vegas folks over there. Raquel.
Okay, okay.
And Aaron, I guess. Go Live
Vegas. Go Live Vegas Studios, a unique multi-camera social media virtual content
So it's, you know, it's all good. Yeah. But that's the lucky, that's the being in the right place at the right time, being prepared for being at the right place at the right time. It would be like if someone said to you, well, I've heard of you. Do you have a CD? Oh, yeah, I'm right here in my handbag. It's like, you know, it's just, it's like the thing with me is that our talent can be brought up in a minute. So we can do what we need to do right here.
You still want to go too.
To do
so, you roll and have one more break after this. You want to go to this one?
People need to find a way to remember you in a way that is different than everybody else.
Greg Ford is niece and daughter, right?
But I think you might four wall.
There's always been something.
Get the other one here.
Yeah, right. And
okay. What do we got?
We have 1 minute.
1 minute.
This hour just flies by.
Well, this is a fast one. Coming back to you.
Are you going back to her?
Yeah, well, she needs to set. I'm going to have her set. Oh, yeah, she's coming back to her.
No, I know.
Okay.
There you go. Let's hope it works. Temperamental microphone.
Nobody likes it, especially police, and nobody knows how it will turn out. Spread the word. For de-escalation to work, both parties must de-escalate. Escalation isn't necessary if there is no escalation. Help police by not escalating.
And if
don't
there's
attack
no
or try to disarm an officer, whether it's being asked
actually,
a question,
I do something nice, don't resist, don't post it on social media, and post from this, use this picture. 10 seconds. He's helping the guy get gas.
To learn more about how to help law enforcement accomplish its goals, visit nationalpolice.org.
And we're back on the Las Vegas Rocks Radio Show. I'm Ron Garrett, your host, AM 670 KMCQ, along with the great lineup of guests today. We have Rose Kingsley, Mystic Mona, Neil Portnoy, Tom Hillary, and the great Lou Gazzara back from the ships. He's out there having a good time on those ships, right?
Oh, absolutely.
They are a good time.
On occasion. I took the whole summer off, though, to be here mm-hmm. in Las Vegas.
You got your whole family here? Right?
Whole family's yeah. together, which is nice. And preparing for a big show, like I said, July 27th mm-hmm. at the Italian American Club. And, you know, it's time of the year where a lot of things have already come and gone. We've done Memorial Day. We've done July 4th, which is coming up this weekend. It's already happening. We're in it right now. But by that time, it's kind of a little lull, and this is a nice air-conditioned venue in the evening when the sun is going down, right, where everyone can come and enjoy a classic entertainment. Like I said, this show is going to be a little different. I pulled out all the stops getting these guys together, best of the best of musicians, and we'll be doing some new arrangements as well that haven't been done before over there that are new for me. So that'll be fun. It's going to be a little grittier than you're used to.
Oh, that's, good.
Not as clean, Grandma's Boy.
Gritty. That's it. Fever and funk, grit What's and class, soul and sizzle.
July 27th.
Got it.
And here's a song that's you're after Rose's heart with this one. Let's play Doma. This is Lou Gazzara. You want to sing along with this, Sarah? Okay, that was the last break, so when we come back, we're going to go all around. Everybody gets a shot. You want
to
promote all your things?
The 27th.
Have you seen Mona?
I've heard him.
You have something coming up that you want to promote?
No.
Tiaras?
No. Well, Night of the Witches is until October.
Okay,
so.
I got that too. Okay.
Yeah. Just so. That you can talk about my app.
You what?
Never seen him live perform.
Oh, no, I've seen him sing before, but I've never seen a whole show.
Oh, it's unbelievable.
Okay. So when we come back, this is the last segment.
Yep.
And everybody, we're going to go around the room.
Okay,
so do your final promotions and plugs. And Neil, I'm going to start with you so you can do the
Wham and the Wall of Honor inductees. We're going to do it every Wham with California, which is smart. Because I'm so backlogged. I mean, I've got literally 75 people that are on the wall. But they haven't been inducted.
They haven't
won. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah. You did that, but very tearful during your inductions. Yeah, like a lot of people. Everybody does.
It wasn't that bad, was it?
Crying about that good.
It was a good cry.
Oh, it's a good cry.
And Presley stole the show. He's great.
30 seconds.
Call or message that mentions Social Security that makes you feel threatened and scared. That is not the Social Security Administration. Social Security does not threaten, press you for personal information, or demand instant payment. Social Security does not accept payments by gift card, prepaid debit card, internet currency, or by mail and cash. Criminals use these forms of payment because they
about
are
6 minutes.
Don't fall for it. Hang on.
Bill, about 6 minutes. About 6 minutes in the segment. 6 minutes.
6 minutes and then my music starts?
Yeah.
6 minutes to the music.
Yep, here we go now.
And we're back on the Las Vegas Rocks Radio Show. I'm Ron Garrett, your host. On our last segment with Rose Kingsley, Mystic Mona, Neil Portnoy, Tom Hillary, and Lou Gazzara with Norm Miller out in the back there having a good time watching it all go down. Let's go to Neil for a moment. Hey, Neil, you've got something new you've added to Wham.
Yeah, every year, Wham event, which is second Tuesday of the month at Portnoy Gallery, Wine Art Music. This upcoming July event is Joe Bonanno, guitar playing vocalist, wonderful entertainer. But we started something new. We're going to start getting our backlog of Portnoy caricatures that are on the Wall of Honor actually inducted to the wall. In this upcoming event, it's Linda Moore, Mark Gendel, Denny Mishler, Jazz D'Antino, Joe Bonasorte, and Christine Shebeck. So those are going to be the new inductees to the Portnoy Wall of Honor. It's the second Tuesday of July. I'm not sure the date. I don't have it in front of me. But 6:30, 9:30, you can go to Portnoy Gallery Facebook page. 13th, thank you, Mona. And sign up. It's a $20 entrance fee into the Wine Art Music event, at which we will be doing the new class of inductees.
That's a good idea to start doing that. Thanks. How many do you have in the drawer that you need to post over the next few years?
There's another, I think, 86 more that have to go into the wall, yeah.
Wow.
So these are the people of Portnoy, which is what you created there. Yep. Wonder what's coming up for you in the future. You should know the future.
So there's I have a save the date. Uh-huh. So October 26th is the 6th annual Night of the Witches.
I have a piece of the Night of the Witches from 2021, but I didn't have time to play it. I was going to run that for you.
So funny.
Yeah.
So anyway, it'll be at Grape Street Cafe, mm-hmm. downtown Summerlin. It'll start at 6 o'clock. We are increasing the value of the prizes for the costume contest this year because we've got some great sponsors that are willing to put more money into the work that people are putting behind their costumes. So that'll be October 26th, 2022 at Grape Street. I also have an app. It's called Dice Wisdom. If you go to dicewisdom.com, you can...
And you have a couple of books.
I have those too. But I want you guys to download the app. Because it's only $1.99 to download the app on your phone. And then once it's on your phone, you can ask any question you want, any time of day, anytime. And so it's pretty fun to do. So, and then to get a hold of me, go to mona.vegas. So www.mona.vegas. So that's how you reach me.
Thank you, Rose. Thank you. I mean, Mona. Now Rose.
Now I am Rose.
Now Rose. Rose, run by everything that's coming up for you.
Next Sunday, July 10th.
A week from tomorrow.
Yes, we are doing our trifecta show with Bill Fain mm-hmm. and Alan Glassman, tenor from the Metropolitan Opera, and myself. And we are doing in the afternoon at 3 p.m. Broadway, jazz, and opera. And you can get tickets at, you have it there.
Norm has it. Norm
has it.
Yell it out, Norm.
Yell
it out.
He's looking.
RoseKingsley.com.
RoseKingsley.com.
Or you can phone 725-205-3018.
That's a new number. 725, yes.
3018.
3018.
3018.
702-725-3018.
No, it's
725. 725. Oh, that's right.
Go ahead, say that again, sir.
725-205-3018.
3018.
Or
RoseKingsley.com. That's the easier way. Go to
RoseKingsley.com. And then on August 11th, I will be at Gatsby's, and we're doing an evening of Sinatra. Oh. Her Way.
Sounds good.
Her Way.
Her Way.
Her Way.
That's fantastic.
Yes, and I guess you can get tickets at Gatsby's and RoseKingsley.com.
Yeah. Okay. Lou, plug it again, man. Plug it again.
I got to plug it one more time. I know a lot of people have been asking me how to get tickets for the event coming up on July 27th at the Italian American Club. You have to get them through the Italian American Club, and the easiest way to do that is to call Janine over there at 702-457-3866, 702-457-3866. It's the Italian American Club or IACVegas.com if you want to do the digital high-tech world. But all different styles, everything. We're pulling out all the stops. It's going to be a great concert. One night only, July 27th.
We're going to have you back on the show before that event. And I've already got my tickets, so Tammy and I will be there.
Sounds great. I can't wait.
She's dying to see you and hear you. She thinks you're fantastic, so... And so do we all. Thank you, Lou. Appreciate it. Tom, what do you got to wrap it up with?
Okay, 500,000 people have got to be right. So go to Tubi TV and watch Looks Can Kill. After you're done with that little thrill, go watch Academy Award nominee Mickey Rourke in Commando.
Commando. That's your movies.
Those are indeed.
Okay, great.
Yeah, well, Looks Can Kill, I wrote Commando is financing.
Oh.
Executive producer.
Okay, we still have
another 60 seconds.
60 seconds before the closing music starts? Yeah. Okay, what do you want to talk about? Lunch for anybody? What do we want to do?
Where are you going
for dinner? Huh? Right, what's going on?
I need a lifetime in 60 seconds.
Fine. I thought I'm missing my timing.
Real quickly, the Vegas
40 seconds.
Rocks radio show is the fastest growing radio live on Facebook page and show out there. Stay tuned for next week. Every week, Ron Garrett brings the finest of the entertainment in our great city.
Amen.
The most watched live entertainment radio show in Las Vegas.
Woo-hoo,
for real.
Woo!
For real. So thank you all. Thank you, Rose.
Thank you.
Mona, we'll have you back shortly. Rose, you got to come back with and see us again.
Yes.
Neil, good luck on the Wall of Honor stuff.
Yep.
Tom making movies by telephone now. And Lou back from the cruise ship spending the summer here in Las Vegas. And you're going to do more than... You got Black Tie Vegas back on, Lou?
Soon.
It wasn't. We missed last week. I was looking for it. Yeah.
Yeah.
He'll be back. Okay. Here's Gato Barbieri. This is called Europa. It's one of my favorite songs.
Europa.
Thank you all for listening and watching to the Las Vegas Rocks Radio Show. Our mission each week is to motivate, support, encourage, and promote local entertainers, famous or not. We promote the venues they appear in and all other live music venues. We want everybody to work. Making us, as I just said, the most watched live entertainment radio show in Las Vegas. Thanks to studio producer Mark Thomas. I say it every week, I love being here to chat with the very best Vegas has to offer. I'm Ron Garrett, and remember this, live fearlessly, but run towards life. See you next week. Good night.
Thank you everybody for watching on Facebook Live. We're going to stop the feed now. We appreciate you all being here. Tune in next week. I've got two Elvis lookalikes on. I lost my sound at the end. Two Elvis lookalikes and Denise Furlong. So it's going to be a